it's a common thought that a heating and air conditioning system should be based on the square footage of a house, the Department of Energy expects proper system sizing to include how much insulation is found in the attic and walls, what the heat loss gain calculations show, ceiling heights, and more. Think about it. If you place your hand on an exterior window on a 100-degree day, that glass will feel pretty warm. That heat you're feeling is making its way into your home, which is called heat gain. In the winter, that heat escapes through the windows and walls, which is called heat loss. Consider this. If only square footage was taken into account, then let's compare a 1,600 square foot home and a 2,100 square foot home. On the 1,600 square foot home, the insulation in the attic may be about 2 inches thick, but it's 140 degrees in the attic, and we're trying to keep it at 75 degrees in the home. 2 inches of insulation in the attic may not be enough to prevent the hot attic air from entering the house. Now, add in the window sizes. If you have two large windows about 150 square feet in size, imagine the heat gain you'd receive on those two windows. But on the 2,100 square foot home, you have R36 insulation, less window space, meaning less heat gain, and better insulation in the walls. While the square footage varies in both homes, they can use the same size system because the larger home is more energy efficient. There are a variety of measurements and calculations, not just square footage, that need to be taken into account to determine the right size system for your home. Go to AireServ.com for more information on your heating or cooling system, or go to our YouTube channel.